finals footy fever is sweeping Power fans, thousands scrambling for tickets to Saturday's clash with Collingwood. Alice Monfries has met some of the diehards today and she joins us live from Port headquarters. Alice.
Well, Beck, the club says it's been inundated by passionate fans desperate to make their way across the border for the big game. Its eight buses have already sold out and seats at the MCG are selling quickly too.
With the click of a button and within seconds of going on sale, diehard Power fan Michael Mills had his ticket secured.
I had my phone in one hand, I had the computer and the mouse in the other hand, and it was basically 8:30 a.m. this morning clicking on everything and seeing which one came up first.
Already 20,000 tickets have been sold for the elimination clash between the Power and Collingwood at the MCG on Saturday night. Port says it expects up to 12,000 of the Power faithful to be cheering the boys on.
And there's great interest in it. We haven't played an away final, I think, since 2005.
So much interest, the Ticky Tech website crashed.
There was a fair load this morning, but we understand that this afternoon that's settled down.
The next challenge, making it to Melbourne. The club put on eight buses. All seats were taken by 2 p.m. Bus companies are still selling tickets for $180 return. The train starts from $200 but doesn't return until Tuesday. A return flight on the Saturday will cost $450.
Get there any way you can, start walking. So the planes will be full, the buses will be full.
Witnessing a finals berth, all the more meaningful after some tough times for supporters.
Through losing, through financial problems, through the Port Magpies issues, coming through all of that, and being able to play the finals this week, I think makes it all worthwhile.
And they're confident of a win.
I think we can get over them, yeah.
Fingers crossed.
Now also today, the AFL announced what entertainment it has in store for grand final day. We'll have more on that later in the bulletin. Beck.
Thank you, Alice.